Okay, good afternoon everybody. So I'm Dr. Nurwaliza Abdul Wahab from Universiti Pendidikan Sultan Idris Perak Malaysia. I'm going to present you the title of my research, Forest School Concept Based on Indigenous Knowledge for Orang Ahli School from an Expert Perspective. Orang Asli is actually is our Aboriginal tribe in Malaysia. Okay. Okay, indigenous people or orang asli children in Malaysia experience difficulty in understanding the standard curriculum. Okay, the syllabus of schools seems not to match the intellectual understanding of the orang asli children, so it be resulting in loss of interest in class and refusal to go to school. In Malaysian Education Development Plan 2013 to 2025, various Orang Asli education plans have been formulated and implemented to ensure that these children receive quality education. Okay, so I would like to introduce the forest school concept to the Orang Asli children in Malaysia, because forest school uses a curriculum which is focused on the teaching and learning process of the students of all ages, but it's particularly suitable for younger children. But in Malaysia, forest school is still foreign and has not been widely applied by the educators, unlike in the Europe. Activities outside the classroom allow students to be self-sufficient because they can make decisions without interruption, and also provide children with different play opportunities, including the chance to play outdoors and impact children's learning. And forest school also is a good mechanism to promote an environmental education further for all children, and allows children to assess their limitation, feel challenged, and enjoy opportunities to develop their self-esteem and confidence. Then, forest school is a concept to use to assist orang asli children to understand the more straightforward learning process in school based on their environment. Because now you know that they are all in the mainstream, they learn about other people's culture except their own culture. Okay, what about indigenous knowledge? So, indigenous people view the world they live is an integrated whole. Their traditional knowledge, beliefs, arts, and other forms of cultural expression have been handed down through generations. But now, in the mainstream, they don't learn anything about their ancestors' knowledge. This information has been recorded in many forms by non-indigenous and indigenous people. So, orang asli settlements are mainly inland near forests and rivers where food and water resources are accessible. Therefore, orang asli knowledge is comprehensive and in-depth, covering belief, ritual, culture, spiritual, economic, emotional and physical aspect based on the experience of living near nature. So we wanted them to continue learning about their indigenous knowledge in the school syllabus. Okay, what is the problem statement? The lack of education among orang asli children is a significant problem for educators. Over 60% of orang asli children do not reach the minimum level in the subjects included in the primary school assessment test. Primary school education runs for 6 years, yeah, from year 1 to year 6, and the rate of decline in orang asli students is unmatched by the national average. Okay, the government has focused on lessening the dropout rate among orang asli students to 6% every year. Thus, the approach and methods of learning and teaching need to develop new skills and pedagogical know-how for the orang asli student. Then this behavior shows that they have a low interest and low education. Then orang asli have not fully embraced the changes which take place in the educational context of Malaysia. Okay, and then the methodology they are used in this research is a qualitative approach with integrated with a cultural responsive methodology. Okay, 12 experts use purposive sampling technique were chosen from the indigenous field, and community leaders were interviewed. Okay, the average age of the interview subjects was 55 with a range of 45 to 65 years old. Then we conduct semi-structured interview were recorded with the subject consent and letter verbatim transcribed, compiled and compared using protocol interview as an instrument. Okay, what is the finding? So we find out 5 themes. The number 1 is maintaining the identity of orang asli. to ensuring the indigenous knowledge is not forgotten by the orang asli children, and then preserving forests for sustainability, and to make sure we upholding orang asli sense of belonging. Okay, what about maintaining the identity of orang asli? So orang asli are the original inhabitants of Malaysia. They have retained much of their identity, which is distinct from the mainstream population. So experts believe that in an educational context, orang asli should maintain their identity, but in the textbooks do not have anything which orang asli student can relate to. So what this respondent said? They learn about many things at school, but nothing directly about themselves as orang asli. Okay? They learn more about Western culture and Malay or Chinese or Indian culture in Malaysia. So, losing a culture and language is a devastating thing. So I would hope that education department would encourage and formalize a practice where children are given time to understand and at least know their ancestral culture. So indigenous knowledge is vital for orang asli future sustainability. It should be the foundation of orang asli children learning process so that they can sustain such knowledge and be innovative, right? So this indigenous knowledge can be passed down from generation to generation. Okay, ensuring that indigenous knowledge is not forgotten by the orang asli children. They said indigenous knowledge needs to be included in the forest school syllabus so young people can learn, practice and not forget about the knowledge mastered by their ancestors. Okay, this is the most immediate concern for the tribe, as the loss of knowledge and tradition when the natives lost their grip on traditional knowledge, they will suffer real consequences and are affected psychologically. An increasing amount of knowledge is a loss as a result of the disruption of the traditional channels of oral communication. So the acquisition of knowledge and skill need for livelihood does not occur at school, nor does it depend on the skills and behaviors learned in the classroom. Learning succession skill occurs through participation in daily activities through which local knowledge of plants, animal and the environment is socially transmitted. Okay, the next one is, they said they want to preserving forest for sustainability. Okay, the respondent said, in learning about indigenous knowledge, we can indirectly maintain the preservation of forests because orang asli is actually living life that can help the sustainability of the environment. So Colbert indicates that forest school encompasses practical skill which have been shown to build the understanding of the environment and human connection. Through play, orang asli children can gain understanding and appreciation of the natural environment and improve physical, social and emotional well-being. So this process also empowers orang asli children. It allows them to reflect and share their experience, help them understand how their action affect others, themselves and environment. Okay, the last one is to upholding orang asli sense of belonging. The respondent said, most importantly, orang asli children can feel a sense of belonging. When they are at school, they also learn about themselves as part of orang asli community and part of Malaysian citizen. Orang asli find following teaching and learning process challenging because of their weak interaction and communication with the teachers, because Malay and English is not their main language. Okay, this weakness has a negative impact on students learning in diplom. They find very difficult for them to grasp what the teacher teach in the classroom. Thus, attending classes improve mentally toward knowing, comprehending and thinking, and upholds their sense of belonging. According to Cumming and Nash, strategies such as those suggested by forest school can promote a sense of self, sense belonging and related relational connections. Okay. The conclusion is, to maintain the sustainability of the orang asli community, children are exposed to learning based on their indigenous knowledge. The forest school concept can also have positive impact on orang asli way of life and culture. Children also come out with new approach to make the teaching and learning more interesting to the minority. Okay, and then it keeps orang asli from losing their identity and their indigenous knowledge, which is very precious. Okay, and then the finding also assists to those who participate in designing the syllabus or curriculum for orang asli to include this element of indigenous knowledge, such as cultural traditions, music, folk stories, history, flora and fauna, and also languages. Okay, the recommendation is this finding find that information on how forest school should be implemented to ensure the successful execution of this approach. And then further studies also involving quantitative assessment of education will come out strengthening knowledge in school. Okay, this study would offer the policymakers critical insight how to improve the curriculum. And then more aid, support, training and engagement for teachers are required for the forest school concept to become more conventional method in addressing curriculum goals. Last, the present studies finding also provide input on the professional trainings of teachers in oral assist school. Okay, thank you. That's from me. Move to Prof. Ong. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Nawaliza, for a very interesting concept on a forest school concept that integrates indigenous knowledge.